after having dealt with all the main concepts that we need to know in the chapter of genetics, we are now going to proceed and go into detail of all the various genetic disorders that we need to be aware about. What we need to keep in mind that all the concepts that we did up till now, they form a very strong base for whatever we are going to read and discuss here onwards. So we have to keep those concepts in mind for sure. And with that foundation and with that base, we are going to build up all the diseases that we need to deal with in this particular chapter. Before we go on, let's make a brief outline of all the diseases that we are going to deal with. How do we classify these genetic disorders? So what we are going to start with is classification. What is the classification of genetic disorders? So broadly, these are categorized or classified into three groups. They are broadly categorized into three groups. The first one is referred to as the single gene disorders. Single gene disorders. The second one is known as the very famous, that is, chromosomal disorders. And the third and the last category that we have is known as multifactorial. Multifactorial. So broadly, we can classify genetic disorders into these three categories. Now let's deal with each one of them and see what further categorizations do we have in these broad categories. When we are talking about single gene disorders, these can further be taken up into two categories. Single gene disorders can either be Mendelian disorders, or the disorders which do not follow the classical Mendelian rules automatically become the non-Mendelian disorders. So, on the basis of whether the disease is following the Mendelian rules or not, we have Mendelian and non-Mendelian disorders. What comes under each one of these? Mendelian disorders are the ones that all of us know. These include autosomal dominant, autosomal recessive. Similarly, we have X-linked dominant, and lastly, Y-linked. So we can say either the disorders can be related to the autosomes, autosomal chromosomes, or it can be related to the sex chromosomes. So when we are talking about the autosomes, we'll have autosomal dominant, autosomal recessive. When we are talking about the sex-linked chromosomes, we'll have either the X or the Y. So we'll have X-linked recessive, X-linked dominant, and Y-linked. So all of these are going to form the Mendelian disorders because they follow classical Mendelian rules. The next category, students, that we have is the non-Mendelian disorders. Now, we already know that these will not follow the classical Mendelian rules. But this is that category which has more complex names. So we are just tabulating it over here, but we'll deal with each one of them individually because these are actually more important nowadays. So non-Mendelian disorders include mitochondrial inheritance. Second, a very recent favorite known as genomic imprinting. The third one, which sounds complicated but is very simple otherwise, is known as trinucleotide repeat disorders. And the fourth one that we have is known as germline mosaicism. So under the non-Mendelian, we have these four. That is something to do with mitochondrial DNA, mitochondrial inheritance. Something to do with a new term called imprinting, that is genomic imprinting. Something to do with the nucleotides known as trinucleotide repeat disorders. And some new terms like germline mosaicism. So these are the newer terms which students are less familiar with and are more favorites nowadays in all the exams. So all of these students, whether Mendelian or non-Mendelian, were under single gene disorders. The other category that we have is known as the chromosomal disorders, and these can also be further categorized into two. Either there is a problem with the structure of the chromosome, so these are known as structural disorders, or there is a problem with the number of the chromosome, and that is known as the numerical disorder. So either some problem in the structure of the chromosome or some problem in the number of the chromosome. So we have structural disorders and numerical disorders. Partly we have discussed all of these when we were doing the concepts of genetics. All the structural disorders like deletion, ring chromosome, isochromosome, all of those were a problem in the structure. So those were structural defects. Also, we had discussed that if the number increases like trisomy or the number decreases like monosomy, all of those were something to do with the number. So those come under the numerical disorders. So we will be taking up important diseases under these also. And the third and the last one that we have